the Depression. But what I will say, kind of living in the sort of legacy of the Harlem Renaissance, that it fundamentally created an armature of Black modernism that I think all of the work, right, living in this moment comes from. So it is, you know, our aesthetic ancestry. And as such, it lives and it breathes. So that, you know, thinking about the centennial, so much of what we'll do, of course, are honor those incredible ancestors. Because, you know, Harlem is still a place where you can walk down the street and people do recite Langston Hughes, right? That's what we do uptown. So it's not past, is what I'm saying. It's not past, it's present. But in 2020, what we are going to look at is this present, right? And we're going to ask artists that question in ways that do maybe tease out a little bit more of the direct connections to the lived lives, right, of artists at that moment.
Yes.
It's really in those stories that we see, you know, so many of the connections that the Renaissance created.
And just so, you know, there, it's, to me, those images are really just about celebration, you know, and so I really, you know, when I look at them now, I see the connections.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, there are all these, like, you know, hashtags that live life now. You know, people go to a party and they're like, Black excellence. It's like, no, Harlem Renaissance was that. That's just a party you're having. Not a worldwide movement changing.